Welcome, everybody, and thanks for joining us tonight. My name is Mike Bell, and I've been with Corning for over 20 years, long enough to witness some of the revolutionary innovations that are shaping the telecommunications industry today. You see, at Corning, we don't just create products, we solve problems with life-changing innovations. And some of our solutions typically begin when customers bring us problems to solve. It all started when Corning invented the glass envelope for Thomas Edison's light bulb in 1879. In 1947, Corning invented a process to mass produce picture tubes, bringing affordable televisions to the public. But it didn't just stop there. As we all know, TVs became bigger and lighter and flatter. And the glass in the old televisions had some heavy metals in it. With the invention of the fusion draw process by Corning, along with our Eagle XG green glass formulation, we enabled the LCD industry to create larger, environmentally friendly, flat screen displays. In fact, our glass is so pristine that a rejectable flaw is as small as a mustard seed on a football field. A mustard seed on a football field. Another revolutionary innovation was bendable optical fiber. And this solved the problem of getting into tight corners. This fiber enabled fiber to the home, high-density data centers, and now wireless solutions. Corning ClearCurve optical fiber was named Time Magazine's Invention of the Year in 2007. About that same time, we saw the rise of smartphones and touch devices and the need for lightweight, damage-resistant covers. Corning Gorilla Glass is visually stunning, and it protects some of the coolest smartphones, tablets, and notebooks from everyday wear and tear. In fact, Corning Gorilla Glass is on 1.5 billion devices all around the world. 1.5 billion devices all around the world. One of our most recent inventions is an ultra-thin, flexible glass we call Corning Willow Glass. Now, Corning Willow has some properties that make it ideal for solar, touch, and display applications. Corning Willow Glass. Now, sometimes Corning invents in big ways and sometimes in small ways. But what we're all committed to is life-changing innovation. Now, some people ask me, Mike, what drives innovation at Corning? And the answer to that is simple. We believe in possibilities. Like this Corning Gorilla Glass holographic terminal that enables our connected world. And also applications that were depicted in our video, A Day Made of Glass. These were things that we gave you a glimpse of that are right on the horizon, including applications on appliances, in automobiles, and as architectural features all around us. We're even working on antimicrobial glass coatings that inhibit the spread of germs in hospitals. Now, my smartphone is the center of my connected life. This is my primary interface to the digital world, and it houses all the applications that enhance my life. I may be surfing iTunes for the movie that I plan to stream over my Apple TV later that evening, or I could be listening to my favorite music, and through the magic of my Ultimate Guitar Tab app, I can be strumming along on my guitar in just seconds. The smartphone also allows us to interact with our environment. I recently purchased a dish tailgater, for example. And through the dish tailgater app, I simply look through it up to the sky And it literally shows me in the app where the satellites are positioned. Now, I know I have a clear line of sight. I set up the dish. It automatically tunes to the satellite. And moments later, I've got SportsCenter streaming right to the parking lot of a Virginia Tech football game. Now, what's more important is wireless technologies. They're really changing our world. And they're making us much more advanced society. Things like mobile banking for developing countries and public safety, mobile health, and also distance learning. And these are innovations, these are technologies that are truly changing our world. Now, what I think is really interesting about this day made of glass is there's lots of wireless technologies that enable that as well. And I've been with Corning for a while, but I think we have a lot to learn from you, the wireless industry. It's people in this industry that are collaborating to solve some of the most complex problems today. In fact, we're moving from connecting 7 billion people to over 50 billion devices in the Internet made of things. Now, Corning has a vision for wireless. Optical connectivity solutions are at its core, and as we continue to invest in life-changing innovation, we will deliver your connected world across all wireless technologies. At this time, I'd like to introduce Bill Cune, who's going to share with you the next step in the optical network evolution, Corning's One Wireless Platform. Bill?
Thank you, Mike. All right, let me log into the matrix here. So I want to thank you all for coming out tonight and joining us for the celebration and the launch of the One Wireless Platform. As Mike mentioned, at Corning, innovation is really stemming from helping our customers solve their deep problems and developing an understanding of what those problems are. And really nowhere else for our business do we see challenges than in making wireless work inside of buildings. And so we look at what causes those issues and brought those problems on. It really is because we've all developed this connected life that Mike was talking about. What I'd like to do is share with you some of my experiences in my connected life. The bottom line is we're all demanding tremendous bandwidth anywhere that we are at any time. We also demand access to applications. We need content when we need it. And so some of my stories really relate, like Mike, around the smartphone. The smartphone has become my primary access device for the internet and for my connected life. And I think you guys can probably relate to this story. The bottom line is that I'll find myself sitting at my desk in my office, typing an email, a very long email, complete with graphics, you know, that I'm writing on my iPhone, making a lot of mistakes, having a lot of crazy autocorrects because of these huge thumbs. And I'll realize that, oh my God, I'm sitting here right next to my laptop. And the crazy part is I don't switch over to the laptop. I keep going. And I think that's strange, but I think you guys have probably caught yourself doing the same thing. And a couple other things I've noticed is that it's not just the email, it's not just the work applications. There's other critically important things that I do with it. One example is last year during the baseball playoffs, I was able to stream video of the Cardinals' amazing ninth inning comeback against the Washington Nationals. And which was just phenomenal. And so that's important to me. So that's my connected life. And if you can imagine, if you're on that tour and you're trying to make that point and you can't get access to that data to show them, it's pretty painful. So maybe that's not the most productive use of it, but it's an important part of my connected life. And this connected life is really, doesn't stop at the office or when you're on the road. you know, in your home, we have a connected life. And in my house, you guys might be able to relate to this as well. I have, for five people and one cat, I have three iPhones, five iPods, two iPads, three Kindles, and three laptops. And those are just my mobile wireless devices. There's plenty of other wireless devices that are sucking up bandwidth. But on average, then, that's three devices per person and one for the cat. And the cat has actually shown an affinity for the iPad. And it's tough to get it away from the cat. However, my nine-year-old daughter can get it away from the cat. And this is a really interesting story. I'll walk into our game room that has this gorgeous 60-inch smart TV, of course, with a Corning glass display. And I'll find my daughter sitting on the couch with the iPad, and she's streaming Nickelodeon. And of course, you know, I'm wondering why she's not watching on television, but what I'll say to her is, please, and this happened, so please tell me you're on Wi-Fi and not on cellular. And she'll actually say, I have no idea what you just said. But I think the people in this room and Corning and the people at this show are going to continue innovation in wireless so that really none of us will care. What we do know is that while I have the 15 or the 16 devices at home, we know that there, over the next decade, there's going to be billions of devices out there. You know, we're not all going to be carrying them. It's going to be a lot of devices that we're carrying, as well as a lot of embedded devices for machine to machine. The bottom line is all of this is intended to make our lives more efficient, more productive, and more satisfying. And the networks to support all of this are going to need to be broadband and flexible. They're going to need to be able to support multi-operator, multi-band, multi-technology, and multi-services, all on one seamless network. And they're going to need to be able to scale, and they're going to be able to adapt to new ways to deliver this connected life experience. What we need is an optical network evolution. And as you guys know, 80% of data usage is actually in buildings. And bottom line is wireless world needs to rise to solve this challenge of how do we get these networks and this service into buildings where people are consuming this data. And there'll be new distributed antenna systems, new small cell, new seamless Wi-Fi offload techniques. There'll be new spectrum allocated, and there'll be new protocols like 4G, LTE, and MIMO. The bottom line is what we know is that wireless has to move indoors. It's becoming more and more complex, and it's evolving very, very fast. And the challenge is to deploy indoor networks that can stay current and support this innovation that's happening all around us in the wireless world. So to address this challenge, Corning today is introducing the One Wireless platform. This platform was designed to flexibly enable the future of wireless, providing coverage, capacity, and context. This platform enables the continuous evolution of the network inside the building, providing a more capable, more efficient, and more intelligent platform by literally illuminating wireless. These are the elements of the One Wireless platform in a holographic version. You can go to our booth and see the real equipment. But I'd like to use these to actually, and some cases, some examples of real-life customer challenges to highlight the advantages of the One Wireless platform and some of the features and functionality that the platform brings. So we all know about the data explosion. We've been talking about it, how much it's growing every year. But this explosion, of course, is happening where we live, where we work, and where we play. But we all know, unfortunately, especially in this group, that we spend much more time at work than we spend anywhere else. And one of the biggest challenges today that is facing CIOs is the need to continually upgrade their networks to meet this demand and this growing demand. The Wi-Fi networks are actually getting to the point where greater than 1 gigabit per second is going to be needed per single access point. and more power is going to be needed than can be delivered by the traditional copper networks. And for cellular, we've all been in this business of deploying cellular networks. We've deployed several, sometimes in the same building, every 4 years, going in and updating them, because they don't adapt well to the needs of where wireless is going. Either a higher frequency comes along, or you want to do MIMO. And the bottom line is these copper networks, they're great, they've got their place, but we believe that the solution is deploying an infrastructure that can adapt, evolve, and keep up with the wireless world. We believe fiber needs to penetrate deeper into the network. Right now it goes from the base of the building up to closets. We believe it needs to go from the closet out to the edge of the network. And we think that we need to use copper for what Thomas Edison, a great Corning co-innovator, what he intended it for, which is power. And we developed these solutions with composite cable, hybrid cable, that provides virtually unlimited bandwidth and ample power over a structured cabling solution that will enable the future of wireless. So let me take a look at another example. Because we're not always at work. Sometimes we get to go to a football game, or in my case, a baseball game. And the bottom line is, when we do get to play, we want to play hard, we want to have a great experience, and quite frankly, we want to show off to all of our friends that we're having this great experience. So, you know, we all want to upload videos, and if you think about 70,000 fans trying to do the same thing at the same time, obviously, it creates a big problem, and a lot of bandwidth is required. And so then, think about owners developing guest portals and providing special content. And it could be stats and data that gets downloaded and available to you. Also, it's replays, very quick replays, so you can sit there and blog about how horrible the call was. And the bottom line is, these stadiums need a lot of bandwidth, and they need a lot of flexibility to deliver that bandwidth and to change over time. So past stadium deployments have only had one or two sectors. And now, people are putting in 10, 20, 30 times that capacity into these stadiums. And so what you need is a network that can adapt. Not one that does two or three sectors today, and then go put in a new one that does 10 sectors, and another one that does 20. You need one that can adapt with the infrastructure accommodating wherever you're going to take this. The head end unit of the One Wireless platform actually provides that interface to the wireless carrier's capacity sources, provides the flexibility to do exactly what I just talked about. It is an intelligent, multi-layered, and modular platform. The layers within this chassis can support MIMO or multiple sectors. The modularity, just plug in modules to enable connectivity to another sector. And the intelligence actually comes from the fact that there's an RF switching matrix inside of this box that allows you to decide where you want the capacity to go and set that up with software and make switches. And you can even decide to invest in the amount of capacity that you need on a particular band and where you want it to go, and you can steer it to adapt to needs. So let me use another example. Because it's not always a baseball game or a football game. It could actually be an event that is the English Premier League football match. And after that, it's entirely possible that you could end up in the hospital. So it's true. So the bottom line is, no wireless environment is more mobile and more complex than a hospital. There's critical applications running on these networks, both within the hospital and throughout the city, because healthcare professionals are very mobile. And they need access for life-saving applications. The bottom line is, it could be fast access for patient records. It could be a specialist needing to read a CT scan from somebody that came into the ER. Or it could just be a nurse trying to monitor the vital signs of a patient that is both the mobile, the patient and the nurse are mobile somewhere in the hospital. The bottom line is healthcare is complicated. And it is the first industry to widely adopt location services. It may be that you want to find an infusion pump that's somewhere hidden on the floor. We've heard stories about 30% of their infusion pumps can't be found. So there's valuable applications here. It could also be that you want to have an alarm go off if somebody brings the wrong medication into a room. The point is that with the advent of cellular and with cellular chipsets and machine to machine, getting into more and more devices, those billions of devices, that we're going to need a mechanism where we can locate cellular services in a precise way. And the challenge with traditional DAS solutions, we all know, is that they combine the signals from all the antennas and come back to a head end. The One Wireless platform is designed actually to address this, and the fact that there is a unique and dedicated connection from the head end out to every single antenna point. The optical interface unit is what provides that capability. Like the head end unit, it's an intelligent, multi-layer and modular platform, but it also enables one-to-one access to these fibers. What you can do with that one-to-one access is really whatever the future decides we can do, but the things that we've thought of and that we're working on are precision location services, directing a particular service to a particular part of the hospital, because quite frankly, hospitals have different networks and different departments and different areas. And you can deliver a hotspot of capacities. For example, the cafeteria, you may want to put an extra bit of capacity down into the cafeteria area. And also the solution with that one-to-one can deliver RF intelligence. So kind of awareness of the network, what's going on in the environment that is on a one antenna per antenna basis. So very powerful capability. And the One Wireless platform and the optical interface unit are what enable that and make that possible. So where do I want to go next? Let's go to the remote antenna unit, or the remote access unit. So closely related to the hospital is hospitality. The needs are similar, but the guests aren't sick. The food is much better, and your bill at the end of your stay is much, much lower. And in hospitality, you'll have 1,000 rooms and a big casino or a big convention floor with thousands and thousands of people, and every one of them is carrying their own devices, or 3 or 16 of them, maybe has their cat with them. But bottom line is they're generating a tremendous amount of demand on every known operator, on every band, on every technology. And the bottom line is you need a solution that actually can support that. And the remote access unit is actually the access point in our network where the wireless signals come into the network. And we converge multiple services there. As a DAS, as a distributed antenna system, this device supports multiple bands with independent control on each of the bands. And it's quite a few bands, and it's in a nice, small, compact, IT-friendly access point-looking device. It also has built-in MIMO antenna. So as still an access point in that package, you can do MIMO over your DAS. Now your MIMO also, now that's if you want to put it up and replace a ceiling tile, very simple deployment. If you don't want it to be visible, it'll take external antennas and you can tuck it away somewhere in a corner. What's really interesting about this remote antenna unit is that like the head end of the system, it's also modular. We can add more capacity to this with an RF expansion slot. We can add a couple bands of MIMO or a couple bands of new capacity on some existing bands. Or we could add some additional bands. New bands like 2600 or WCS could be added to the system by plugging in a module. Now this thing isn't just a DAS as well. As we talked about this, it's a wireless enablement platform. And this module, this unit, also has a digital expansion slot where we have a card that plugs in that enables gigabit Ethernet over fiber. And so this unit simultaneously supports multiple bands of DAS and gigabit Ethernet. And that gigabit Ethernet can support Wi-Fi access point, it could support a small cell, and quite frankly, it can also support wired devices. There's no reason why it can't go down to a switch sitting on a desk. So it really is a nice convergence of wireless and wired all over a single common platform. And so what we do know is about the future of wireless is that really the convergence of RF and digital and the support of both is necessary. We know that there are digital architectures out there in the future of wireless. We know that there are small cells that require Ethernet backhaul, and we know that DAS is going to continue to be important. So what you really need is a converged solution that can support all of those. The other thing that's interesting about this solution is because we have fiber all the way out to the edge, and we actually have a customer right now that we're deploying this, they're doing a passive optical LAN system for their LAN network. And follows very much the same architecture. And so we're using the One Wireless platform and its ample fiber out to the edge to support wireless, to support Wi-Fi, and to support the entire LAN network in the building. So it truly is a powerful converged story. Uh-oh, did I go too far? So key to the enablement of our connected life, whether we're in the office or at the baseball game or visiting a sick soccer hooligan friend in the hospital, you know, or spending a week in Vegas, really is the deployment of high bandwidth networks that are really needed to address this complex and evolving wireless world. These networks need to be able to support DAS, Wi-Fi, and small cell, plus other innovations that come along, many of which we may not totally be aware of yet. But ones I can think of course, are location and some RF intelligence to support self-organizing networks. They need to be able to support that. They need to be smart networks that provide these value-added services so that the city-wide networks can operate better together. They need to be agnostic networks where high bandwidth pipes are ready to support transport of any RF signal or any digital signal. And they need to be flexible networks that allow capacity investment to be optimized and placed anywhere in the system. At a few locations within the city, centralized at a few locations within the city, perhaps at the head end of a building, maybe on a particular floor, or out at the edge of the network. The bottom line is the network needs to be able to support all of that. And the One Wireless platform will support the future of heterogeneous networks and this flexibility. So, in summary, the One Wireless platform will solve many of the challenges facing our customers today. Bottom line is it provides more bandwidth, more features, more capabilities, with more flexibility over a virtually bandwidth unlimited infrastructure using modular and intelligent equipment to deliver a one-of-a-kind network solution. So where are we going? Let's go back to my connected life and where do I see this aside from the cat, I actually want to be like my daughter. You know, I simply want to have a connected life that works and not really worry about the other stuff. I mean, I'd like my smartphone to be a key fob that could leverage any nearby display so I can have a HD video conference. And I want a real life experience witnessing a, you know, grandchild being born while my connected life hologram is in Las Vegas doing a product launch. But I do expect many more innovations out of the people at this show and in this room and out of Corning and all of our partners that are gonna help make this a reality. The bottom line is the One Wireless platform that we announced today is just the beginning. So thank you.